In this edition of Inside Bluehost Football, Presbyterian College takes their show on the road up north, close to New York City, actually West Branch, New Jersey, as they take on the Hawks of Monmouth. We'll have a visit with the coach, take a look at those highlights, and talk about a lot more as we wind down this season of Inside Bluehost Football.
Inside Bluehost Football is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. By Fats Cafe of Clinton, making your tailgate deliciously easy. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you to this edition of Inside Bluehost Football. Along with the coach, Harold Nichols, I'm Eric Thacker. Glad that you could spend this Saturday with us. Well, coach, we said it many, many times each and every week. The Bluehost just right here going up against a Monmouth team on their senior day. But again, I have to say this. Congratulations to you. Despite our win-loss record, the kids have played hard and they have battled everybody in conference play all the way into the fourth quarter, and we just, you know, just a few points away.
Yeah, we can't seem to get over the hump right now. Right. You know, we're right there. You know, really as a coach, all that you can ask from a football team is that they'll, you know, give you great effort. You get to the fourth quarter with a chance to win.
Right.
And every game, probably outside of the Charlotte game, that's been the case, you know.
Exactly.
Which is a credit to our coaching staff, which is a credit to our kids. They're very resilient. And I wish I had answers for them. I really do. You know, it's hard to put your finger on just one thing. You know, obviously, you know, we've played pretty consistent defensively all year long.
Absolutely.
We've missed some chances on offense at times. We've got a young quarterback playing right now. You know, there's all kind of woulda, shoulda, couldas. But at the end of the day, you know, our kids are playing the game the right way. Mm-hmm. Been really proud of the way that that they showed up each and every Saturday. And I think for our fans out there, you know, I think that that's something that they can be proud of. You know, our kids are coming to compete every week. And it's my job as a head coach to get them over that hump. We're working diligently to do that. Myself and our coaching staff are working all day, every day, you know, to try to get that elusive victory right here. And so it's frustrating. It's been a frustrating year in a lot of ways, no doubt. But I do see a lot of good things in our football team.
That's
and,
right.
I really think moving forward, I think we've got a chance to have a really good football team and a really good program.
Let's talk about this for a second, Coach. You've had your tenure here.
Mm-hmm.
You've been at Georgia Southern. You've been other places as an assistant coach. You've been around a lot of young men during your coaching career. You know, it's one thing to not be enabled to compete because you don't have the talent in losing badly each and every week. But again, you guys compete all the way into the fourth quarter. Is it more difficult to keep a team up when you're that close to winning, not just a game here or a game here, but each and every week you have a chance to win? And if you don't get that W, is it harder to get those guys to stay motivated than it is if you know, look, we're not as talented as the other team?
Well, you know, I don't think it has anything to do with talent. I think, you know, we've gotten our program up to a point where, you know, our talent level and our depth level is to a point where we can compete each and every week.
Right.
And it's taken us a while to get there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, unfortunately, the wins haven't come like I wanted them to this year. But, you know, I think, you know, having the ability to get your team up ready to play each week, I think that comes out of the locker room. I think that starts back in January, you know, when you're building a football team and, you know, that chemistry we have in our locker room. And I've been really proud of the way that our kids have done that. And, you know, our seniors, our leadership, you know, which we're going to honor them this week. You know, a lot of credit goes to them because they're about the right things. They've got a lot of pride in what they do. They've committed a lot of time and effort into our program. So I would say no. I would say the answer to that is no. You know, I think a team that's, you know, consistently losing and losing by big margins, that's a hard thing to have to overcome because they don't see light at the end of the tunnel.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, you know, hopefully we'll see the Bluehost close out with a win against Kennesaw State, which, by the way, it's going to be a fantastic afternoon here on the campus of Presbyterian College. Come on out and join us. It's going to be a wonderful time, no doubt about it. Well, Coach, I think we can say this again, and we bring up that word football character. Mm-hmm. There's no doubt. You have football character, your coaching staff has football character, and obviously the kids do because they leave it on the field each and every week. So we have a lot to be proud of. Let's go ahead and take a look as we begin with the offense. The offensive highlights, PC and the Hawks of Monmouth.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Well, here we have the offensive highlights. They had downed a punt, I think, inside of our 10. And so we had to knock it out here and try to get a first down, try to get some room to work. And there's Darryl Bridges coming out and almost gets out of the pile right there.
That was a touchdown if he gets away, right?
Yeah, I mean, you're just a half a step away right there of going 99 with it. But, you know, Darryl, like I say, you know, still has got that ankle, and I think he came up a little bit limping on this one. It might have been his last play. We're coming back, going back towards the scoreboard here. Got a little trip set to the field, and Quaylen Patterson's in there at back and run a little bootleg here, and Ben Cheek does a nice job finding Markell Hines, finally back healthy for a big third down conversion there. You can kind of see the end zone shot of it, and see Ben coming out and throwing a nice ball right there on the run and getting a good first down right here. I think this might have been our drive to go up here. We got trips down here to the bottom. Again, you know, Monmouth's very good defensively on their football team. We've run a little trap right there, and there's Quaylen Patterson, you know, really doing a good job creasing them right here and getting a good 10, 12-yard gain. Again, like I say, you know, the game is slowing down for Ben a little bit, and hopefully we can kind of help him out. Quaylen making a nice cut, getting a good first down right there. I think this is on that same drive. Got a little play-action pass set up here, I think, where we're going to hit Trayvon Howell right there on the up-and-go. Wish he'd have put it out there just a little bit farther right there. Might have had a touchdown catch, but... But good play action. You can see the safety number 23 right there step up with the run action. And then we just skin off of his hip right there and got to really put that one up there and get the ball inside the 5-yard line here. Got a little tight end and a little trip set here. Trying to get our young quarterback here in the best play. Run a little pass right here. We got, you'll see Deshaun Davis right there on the inside running a post route. We stick him right there off the break and sit him down in the hole. And good touchdown pass right there by Ben. Yeah, he had pretty good protection with the OL. Again, like I say, trying to get him in the best play. Sometimes we'll play fast. Sometimes we'll slow it down, depending on how the game's going. Tempo is such a big part in college football anymore. But you can see Ben, you know, get more comfortable, does a nice job sitting in there and throws a strike and just sits him down. And that's the offensive highlights.
Well, Coach, I know we've had some injuries in our backfield. Boy, Blake Roberts could have had a big game in that one if he was available. So the team having to overcome that adversity offensively. But baptism by fire, the redshirt freshman, I tell you what, you see these intangibles that this guy has or quality that he has, and you said the game is going to become slower and slower for him, a redshirt freshman, so the future is bright there for number 8.
Yeah, I think so. I think he did some good things in the game. You know, made some mistakes. You know, I mean, there's a learning curve that those guys will go through. But you look at Deshaun Davis and Quaylen Patterson, some of those young guys that are making impacts for us.
Didn't want to leave them out.
No, of course not. And, you know, so I think that, you know, the future is bright for those guys. And, you know, Ben's going to be a really good player for us here. And we got to keep working.
Mm-hmm. Windy in West Branch, New Jersey, as we dive in, take a look at our special teams highlights because the wind did play a major factor.
Here we got our special teams highlights. Here's our punt team out here, and Brent Cameron does a nice job on the snap. Big hit right there by Grant Beidel. Does a nice job. And Stephen Doerr, I can't tell you how much the wind played a factor in this
Huge.
Game right here. There were gusts up to 45 mile an hour winds. And we were kicking into the wind right there. And for Steven to get that out there and hit a low line drive like that, credit him. Here we are, we're kicking back into the wind here. Steven does a nice job right there, driving the ball into the wind, getting some carry. Mm-hmm. There's freshman Kenny Coleman right there for the fumble recovery. That was a big play in the ball game. Did a good job protecting and covering all day long on the punt team. You see Grant Bidle down there again. Kenny Coleman right there where he's supposed to be. That's a big turnover in the game. Continue to be impressed with Brett Norton, our kicker.
Boy, he sure has come on.
He has, and has done a nice job. You know, here we are. We've got a mid-range field goal. And, again, you can see this kick because it starts out. I told him, you know, you need to start it out at the left upright, and it'll fall in between the two uprights. So if you can see him right here, we got good protection, good operation. And see that thing kind of bend, bang, and curve back in? I'm telling you, the wind was a huge factor in the ball game. I think we're going to get a decent punt return here, something we work on extremely hard in practice of trying to get good body position and good blocks. They're a pro-style punt. Deshaun Davis continues to make progress as a returner. He's a very dangerous guy. He can make you miss. You can see him here. It's hard to hem him up in a phone booth. But, you know, guys are fighting and working hard, trying to get a decent return. You can see the end zone shot of it here. You can see Deshaun again. Now, they're kicking with the wind here. And I know you can see the flags on the sticks, but, you know, it was a consistent 15 to 20-mile-an-hour winds with gusts up to 40, 45. And there was wind advisories out there on the coast. We were pretty close. But you can see Deshaun sticking it right here, getting north and south. I think he had right at 40, 45 yards punt return on the day. It's good for your net punting, and that's our special teams highlights.
Well, Coach, special teams getting better. I tell you what, in all aspects of the game, kick coverage, punt return, kick return, the kicking game, much improved. In weather conditions like that, boy, that wreaks havoc. So congratulations to everybody.
Yeah, I think, you know, operations, cover units, protections, I think we were – you know, and those are really big things that keep us in ball games.
That's
right. And when I talk about playing the game the right way, that's what I'm talking about. You're not hurting yourself on teams. You're not hurting yourself with, you know, blocked punts, fumbles, you know, bad operations
exactly.
On extra point and field goal, all those things. I mean, we've been pretty much on point all year, knock on wood. So we've got to continue to do that against a good Kennesaw team coming up. But, you know, there's no reason in my mind why we won't. Steven averaged 44 yards a punt, you know, in that wind, you know, which is a credit to him.
And a few of those knocking into the wind.
So really, really proud of all those kids, no doubt.
All righty, Coach, let's go ahead and take our first time out. When we come back, again, the star of the game was the defense. Boy, they rise to the occasion each and every week. We'll have that, plus the Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week when we return right here on Inside Blue Hose Football.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance of Clinton. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there. Cooper Motor Company, sales and service of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram trucks since 1938. Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
We're fighting cancer with caring. With technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
Hey, what do you think that sign says?
Eat more ch. What is ch?
Well, it's the start of a word. Something like eat more cheese or eat more chili.
Chocolate, eat more chocolate.
No, no, it's chowder.
Chimichangas.
Cheesecake.
Chewing gum. It could be chewing gum.
That's not how you spell chicken. I'm pretty sure.
Half lemonade, half ice cream. Frosted lemonade, starting at 240 calories.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Football. We said the Blue Hose made the trip up to West Branch, New Jersey, but they did drive through the big city. Harold, if you would, tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, we flew into LaGuardia, and were able to take the kids down through Times Square and through Manhattan there and saw the 9/11 Memorial. It was really a neat experience for a lot of our kids. You know, had never been in New York City, number one, and some of them never flown on a plane, you know, so it was a great experience, you know, and that's part of being a college student athlete. You know, you get a chance to go and see places that you probably would have never had the opportunity for. So we were happy to be able to do that, and as we went up there on Friday.
All righty, the defense holds a special place in your heart, especially the last couple of years and this year. Again, keeping us in the game in the fourth quarter each and every week. Let's go ahead, dive in, and take a look at the defensive highlights.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Here we've got our defensive highlights. Monmouth's got some dangerous players offensively. You know, we had to do a good job of getting lined up and playing fast. I thought our DL, for the most part on the day, did a pretty good job. Daly, their quarterback, is a guy that can make plays with his arm or his legs. They run a little sit-down route, and then there's Donnell Williams with a big pick here. Kind of a strange way the play unfolded. They caught the ball. We stripped the ball. Ball popped up, and Donnell just it just happened to land in Donnell's arms. You know, and this is, you know, in the first series. It's kind of strange the way that it happened. But, you know, Deron Dickey with the big stick right there, and do a nice job. I wish Donnell had younger, healthier legs right there so he could have got all the way to the house, but very opportunistic play by Donnell there. Here we're back we got them behind the sticks here a little bit. They're in a second and long deal. They've got a little bunch set here. They run a little toss play, and there's Uganda Akko. Has been big all year.
The monster's been playing great.
You know, he really has. He kind of sniffs this one out. You know, he's right there to make a big play for another tackle for loss. Here we are. We got him at third and eight. You know, like I say, you know, you got to do a good job with your rush lanes here, especially against a guy like Daly, who can run exceptionally well, run a little play-action pass, and try some verticals right there. And there's Jaycee Yeldell. Right there, having him step up. Nice job by Jaycee on his rush lanes, and a good job by those tackles sitting in there and not giving him another place to go. Kind of filters him right back in there to Curtis Bay with a big sack right there. Nice job by Jaycee and Curtis. Here they are in another bunch set here and try to run a little power, and there's Donnell Williams, boom, which is probably a good candidate for our Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week. You know, and he had a couple of sticks like this, you know, big tackles for loss and big plays during the game. Just real proud of him, you know, the way that he's gone. This is a fourth down and short play. They try to get us off sides, and boom, there's I think that might have been Ugano for the big tackle for the loss here, but there's actually it was Cameron Mack. Nice Cameron's play by Cameron. I knew Cameron and Ugano both were over there. Did a nice job. There's Derek Washington getting a nice bubble here on the on the zone. You can see him here taking the center back, making him bubble, and there's Ed Britt for another big tackle. Those are the defensive highlights.
Well, the Blue Hose have been blessed with some great defensive players the last few years, and tell you what, Donnell Williams, Ed Britt, two of the finest that have graced the uniform at Presbyterian College. Well, now it's time to take a look at our Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week. Nichols Automotive, your home for all of your automotive needs, and of course, Yokohama Tires.
And here we have the Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week. Like I talked about before, is Donnell, boom, knifing in, getting him behind the sticks. Nice play. Donnell played really well. Probably played one of his better games all year. He was all over the field. Definitely a player that has been an impact player for us for many years, and that's the Collision of the Week.
Well, there he is, Donnell Williams, with another stop for the Blue Hose. Let's go ahead and take our final timeout. When we come back, we'll take a look at the health of the team as we take a look at our Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, and of course, the Chick-fil-A look ahead to this Saturday's opponent.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
There once was a family, a lot like this one, and they were traveling far away where there were no Bojangles. The family needed breakfast, but they'd gotten a late start. They pulled up to a drive-thru of a strange restaurant, and a loud voice boomed. We stopped serving breakfast at 10 a.m.
Oh, honey.
At Bojangles, we've always served breakfast all day. Come in for a Cajun filet biscuit today. Bojangles, it's bow time.
Hi, this is Harold Nichols, head football coach here at Presbyterian College. Do you need some help simplifying your life? Matt Davis has helped me, and he can help you too. Go see Matt Davis and his great team at State Farm in Clinton, South Carolina. They will handle your auto, home, and life insurance so you will have more time to handle everything else in life. You could earn discounts up to 40%. Sounds like a touchdown to me.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Bojangles, it's bow time. And by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Jeff Smith and Allstate.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Football, the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report. Coach, if you would, please.
Well, I think that, Darryl's leg injury, kind of crept back up there in the first quarter. But I think other than him, I think we came out of it relatively healthy. As healthy as we can be this time of the year. I don't think there's anything really major that came out of the game that will keep anybody out from this last ball game.
All right, Ian, let's go ahead and take a look at the next, this Saturday's opponent, the Chick-fil-A look ahead.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
All righty, Coach. Kennesaw State Owls, their first year with football, playing some very good football. They're well coached. They have a very good running quarterback. Break down this game for us, if you would.
Well, they run an option type offense similar to what Wofford runs, Georgia Tech. Coach Bohannon, who I've known for a long time, has done a really good job building that program there. They've got some really good players. They've been recruiting to it for 2 years now.
And
they've got some junior college guys. They've got some transfer guys in there. They're a very good football team. They're 6-4. They've had a schedule that's allowed them to have some success this first year, which has been really good for them. So much respect for Coach Bohannon and his coaching staff. They've done a really good job there, and they've had a good year. They beat Gardner-Webb 12-7. They beat Monmouth at home 23-13. They're a good football team. So it'll be a big challenge. One thing for us, it's senior day. We're honoring 23 seniors that have been so important
That's
to our program.
Special,
no
it?
Question about it. So it'll hold a this class holds a special place in my heart. We certainly won't miss them. We'll be able to honor them the right way. So come on out to Bailey Memorial Stadium and let us send these 23 seniors off the right way.
Absolutely, Coach. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. This reminder, big busy day on the campus of Presbyterian College. We close out football with Kennesaw State. We also entertain the Bulldogs of the Citadel on the hardwood in the Templeton Center at 7. It's Presbyterian Youth Day here, and admissions people are here as well, as we look forward to welcoming in some future students. For the coach, Harold Nichols, I'm Eric Thacker. Till next week, go Blue Hose.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Smith Chevrolet of Lawrence, providing premier new car sales and service in Lawrence for over 60 years. By Palmetto Bone and Joint, the official orthopedic care provider for PC Athletics. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College. We would like to thank the following Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors: The Bud Group, Good Times Entertainment, Carolina Concrete, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, Midway Barbecue, Hannah Heating and Air Conditioning, Epting Turf and Tractor, Arthur State Bank, Carolina Auto Sales of Clinton, Wilson's Cafe, Tony's Pizza, and Steamer's Cafe.